Hello everyone, this is Ravens from DJ Integrity. Today we are going to see some interesting tech news in episode 265. If you are using an Android smartphone, then you need to check immediately if your device is infected by this infamous piece of malware, which can end up costing you a lot of money. This malware is called as Joker malware, one of the most persistent threat actors that keeps coming back to the Google Play Store. It was first detected in 2017 and became the most popular choice of cyber criminals to invade phones of Android users. In 2019, Google Play Store has also published a long blog post about its fight with the Joker malware. Facebook, operated by the CEO Mark Zuckerberg under the parent company Meta, has been voted as the worst company of the year on Yahoo's Finance Annual Survey of 2021 that shortlisted the company of the year based on the performance and achievements of the firm worldwide. While Microsoft aced the race by shattering the $2 trillion market capitalization this year and up to 53% surge in the stock price as of December. Social media giant Facebook rebranding this year to Metaverse has seemingly upset its users, according to the polling for Yahoo survey. iPhone SE 3 is reported to enter the trial production phase in the near future. It might come with an A15 Bionic chipset and X60 5G baseband modem. Apple is expected to sell around 30 million units of iPhone SE 3 next year. Palghar District Administration conducts drone delivery trials of COVID-19 vaccines from Jawar to Village Zap. On Thursday, a batch of 300 COVID-19 vaccines was delivered to a local public health center in Zap. The drone took around 9 minutes to cover the 20-kilometer distance compared to 40 minutes by road. OnePlus is soon going to launch its OnePlus Note 2 CE in India. The device has now received Indian BIS certification, suggesting an imminent launch. The key specifications of this device include a 6.4-inch AMOLED display, 4500mAh battery and a Dimensity 900 processor. OnePlus and its sister companies are leading towards a fast charging race. We recently heard rumors that the OnePlus 10 Pro will feature an 80-watt fast charging technology, and it will be one of the first phones to offer a blazing fast charging speeds. And Oppo is also rumored to launch a new phone with an 80-watt fast charging technology. All of this may sound a bit confusing, since both OnePlus and Oppo were rumored to add blazing fast 125-watt fast charging technology to their flagship phones. It is possibility that 125-watt fast charging tech will be introduced in the late 2022. Qualcomm has released the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 processor as the latest flagship processor with a reworked name to boot. According to the leaks, this Qualcomm is working on its new processor, which is a successor to the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1. This possibly accelerated timeline might be related to the MediaTek's rising status in the same field. According to the rumors of Realme, Realme is getting ready to launch 4 phones as a part of Realme 9 series for next year. The series are Realme 9i, 9, 9 Pro and 9 Pro Plus. The two ends of the spectrum, 9i and 9 Pro Plus, has now appeared on online, giving us a few more bits. Please check out the screen for the camera specifications for the 9i and 9 Pro Plus smartphones, which has been leaked online. Realme GT 2 Pro was announced in a virtual event. This smartphone features a 150-degree FOV ultra-wide camera. This device is made out of a bio-based material. Redmi Note 11 4G has appeared on IMDA and EEC certification website with the model number displayed on the screen. This handset is expected to debut in global market soon with the Snapdragon 680 chipset. Redmi Note 11 4G specifications include a 50-megapixel triple cameras, 90Hz LCD display and MIUI 12.5 OS. Samsung Galaxy S21 Fan Edition will be available in two models, 6GB RAM 128GB storage and an 8GB RAM 256GB storage. The listing shows a 6GB RAM 128GB storage will be priced at €769, that is approximately ₹65,800, while the 8GB RAM 256GB model is listed at €839, that is around ₹71,800. The Samsung Galaxy S21 Fan Edition is expected to launch at CES in January. Infinix plan to launch a 5G smartphone in January. The company will launch around 5 to 6 smartphones in India within the first half of 2022. Infinix would also launch a 55-inch smart TV sometime. Infinix will also bring in more laptops to India in 2022 as well. The Vivo S12 series will be arriving on Wednesday on December 12th, and we already know that the phone will arrive a triple camera setup on the back with two more shooters at the front. According to the short video teaser released by Vivo, and it will be revealing selfies will be further improved with two LED lights. Vivo is putting two flashes at the front of S12 Pro, which will be embedded into a thin bezels on the top. The Vivo Watch 2 design has been officially revealed in China, which is ahead of the December 22nd launch. Vivo is partnering with China's three biggest telecom firms to enable SMS via standalone eSIM on the Watch 2. Vivo Watch 2 will let users communicate via SMS without having it paired with a partnered smartphone over Bluetooth or Wi-Fi. According to the latest report, Xiaomi Mix Fold 2 will be using an 8.1-inch UTG AMOLED flexible screen from the Samsung display. The UTG display is thinly processed at the level of 30 microns and is made through a process that improves flexibility and durability. Krafton has begun Christmas celebrations in BGMI with new and returning game modes. BGMI gets Squid Game-inspired React Survival mode that plays out just like a red light and green light. Six returning game modes including Virus Infection, Metro Rail, Survival Till Dawn and others will be added to BGMI soon. A YouTuber video of an unhappy Tesla owner in Finland who blew up his car by using a dynamite has caught the world's attention. After using a 2013 Model S electric sedan for 8 years, the owner started having trouble with it. He was getting a multiple error codes on the instrument cluster due to software glitches that even affected the car's semi-autonomous driver assistance system. Finally, he used a low truck to take it to the nearby Tesla service center. After a month-long wait, he received a call from the Tesla company service engineer saying that entire battery pack needs to be replaced as the problem cannot be fixed. It would cost him around 20,000 euros as no warranty was available for it at this time. Any third-party service would have been cheaper, but Tesla had a closed ecosystem that doesn't even allow that. He want to tell to the world that how expensive is the maintenance cost of electric vehicles. So the infuriated Tesla owner decided to blow up the car by using a 30 kg of dynamite. Before the explosion, the owner and his crew set a doll of Tesla CEO Elon Musk inside the car. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow DigiIntegrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.